Good morning and welcome to St. Patrick of Heather Downs. Before we begin, just a quick reminder, please silence your cell phones. And we invite you now to join us in our opening song, which may be found on the inside cover of your worship aid. Here I am, Lord. Would you please stand?
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
A very, very warm welcome to all of you as we gather in this sacred space this morning to celebrate the life on earth and journey to heaven for Joe Franckhauser. It's with mixed emotions that we always gather at the time of death. We gather with the sense of loss. We gather, those of you closest to Joe, really lost a visible source of God's love in this world. But as people of faith, we know that Joe believed in God and is on his way to be in heaven with God forever. As we gather, it's always helpful to tell stories about someone who's passed, because in the telling of the story, their spirit's made present. So I would like you all to be seated and call forth Kelly forward for a family tribute.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. My name is Kelly Walsh. I'm one of Papa Joe's grandchildren. On behalf of the entire Franckhauser family, thank you for those who traveled here today, and thank you for joining us in this celebration of Papa. Our Papa always loved a gathering. Today, our hearts are broken, but we were so blessed to have had him and to share in his long life. For those here, I would like to share a few things about Papa. He was one of five siblings raised in Steubenville, Ohio. His career brought him to Toledo, where he and Nan raised their family. He had a career spanning more than 20 years at Page Dairy, where he worked as an engineer, but his favorite job was tasting every flavor of ice cream that was processed, and of course, never gaining any weight. He worked at Page Dairy until it closed, and then went on to create a successful business, Southside Electric and Refrigeration. He worked securing contracts with several notable commercial businesses, and he retired in his 70s. Nana and Papa had many travel adventures, both domestically and internationally, enjoying travel with family and their good friends, Paul and Lois, making many lasting memories. If a person's wealth is judged by their commitment to their faith, their devotion to family and friends, and their love of life, then Papa Joe Franckhauser was a very rich man. He always had a story to tell, loved to share his wisdom and knowledge. He was a good friend to many, but most of all, he was a wonderful husband, proud father, grandfather, and great-grandfather. To our family, he leaves an unforgettable legacy. His love, his laugh, the memories made, and the life lessons will always stay. These are his gifts to us. Papa Joe, forever loved, forever remembered, forever in our hearts.
Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Joe died with Christ. May he now be with God forever in heaven. On the day of his baptism, like all of us, Joe received a white garment. They didn't wear white because they couldn't clean it, so white became pure and to symbolize oneness with God. Now we place another white cloth, the pall, on his ashes to be a reminder throughout the ceremony that he's on his way to be with God forever. Let us pray silently for a few moments and call to mind all the things that we want to ask of God for ourselves and our loved ones in this time of prayer. Let's collect these silent prayers. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son Jesus, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant through this mystery your servant Joe, who's gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. May we have the first reading from the book of Ecclesiastes at this time.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to tear down, and a time to build, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones, and time to gather them, a time to embrace, and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away, a time to rend, and a time to sow, a time to be silent, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, time of war, and a time of peace. What advantages has the worker from his toil? I have considered the task which God has appointed for men to be busied about. He has made everything appropriate to its time and has put timeless into their hearts from beginning to end. The work which God has done, I recognize there is nothing better than to be glad and do well during life. I recognize that whatever God does will endure forever. There is no adding to it or taking from it. Thus has God done that he may be revered. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Righteousness and truth, my spirit shall sing the music of your and mercy follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of my God
A reading from Paul's letter to Timothy. I, Paul, am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed and all the Gentiles might hear it. And I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil threat and will bring me safe to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory to you, O Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Pray that the words of this gospel will be in our thoughts, on our lips, remain in our hearts. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. You see, in my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Now Thomas, one of Jesus' disciples, said to Jesus, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" And Jesus said to Thomas, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On behalf of Deacon Joe and myself and all of us here at St. Pat's, just our deepest condolences to all of you. You know, sometimes it's hard to know what to say at the time of someone's death, isn't it? And you know, I'm sure you've had people say, "Gosh, I'm just so sorry for your loss. I don't know what to say." But you know, as people who are baptized and say that they're Catholic or Christian, for those of us who say we believe in God, we do have something to say. If you believe in me, you'll never die. That this isn't all there is. That there really is something beyond this. And that love doesn't die. For those of you closest to Joe, Carolyn, the kids, the grandkids, family, friends, if there is a connection in love and God while someone lives, when their body dies, that connection's still there. 9 years ago, on the morning of my dad's funeral in 2014, a friend of mine who has spiritual gifts calls me and she says, "Get out of bed, write this down. Your dad just talked to me." And he said, among other things, "Relax. I'll be right with you. I'll be with your mom." They were married over 65 years. They've been together longer than that. Their souls were connected, and he was right there, and he's still with me, still. I think one of the biggest surprises that we will experience when we get to the other side is how present our loved ones are. And that when we pray to Mary and Joseph and the saints, they come. When we pray to our grandparents and our parents, when we ask for their prayers, they come and they're here. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God and have faith also in Jesus that he modeled for us. He says, "Relax. Remember when I rose from the dead? Remember when they touched me?" And Thomas said, "I'm not going to bleed till I touch." That is proof to us that Jesus was not a figment of their imagination, was not a dream, that he was real. It was not a human body, because remember, he went directly to Jerusalem and walked through the wall, but it's the body that we all get when we get all the way to heaven. Why else would Jesus come? But to be able to say, look, there is life after this one. I've opened up the door. I've given you a way to be able to see what's ahead of you. So do not let your hearts be troubled. We will put his body to rest this week, but his spirit is alive. It's really interesting thinking and meeting with the family to talk about Joe. You know, certainly one way to describe Joe, somebody said, yep, golf and gin. You know, he loved sports. From everything you said, he loved to play golf. And some people describe his unique stance as like a praying mantis stance. But he loved to play golf, and he loved to socialize. He had stories for everything, maybe a rant here and there, and there was always the humor. Everybody I talked to, it was the humor. It was always kind of like, it's almost like he's like a snake in the grass. He's just sitting there in the chair, you know, we listening, and then boom. Someone said, they were visiting, one of the grandkids said that recently, you know, he was visiting someplace and the living room was empty and there's this tiny little dog named Abigail, and he sits down next to the dog and said, and no one was around. I think it was Chris, the grandson, that just kind of was spying in, and he said, okay, Abigail, what's your story? Sorry, that's hilarious. And I'm sure that you have much funnier stories, maybe not all that can be told in church. There was the humor, there was the love of sports, there was the engineer's mind, right? You know, he studied agriculture, he loved to do things with his hands, and I think there was a part of him that liked things concrete. You know, he built onto the house, right? You know, he started his own electrical company. You know, he made things. There was commitment. You know, there was family in Steubenville. There was his relationship with Monsignor Grigsby and Sister Leah, sorry, I knew I was wrong. And then there was structure to life, you know. Two of you went to high school together, dated later, but there was this structure, but there was something about timing. If I'm correct, he was born on Groundhog's Day and died on leap year. No, I mean serious, and he died on leap day. You know. So then I guess after 4 years of anniversary from then, he'll have his 1 year anniversary. So you feel that he hasn't been gone that long. But there was something about the timing. I mean, you know, he wasn't a spring chicken at 96, but still, the timing of his death caught you by surprise. But you did have those months taking care of him, right, in the home. So you had that time and the family around. And that's why the family and I thought that first reading from Ecclesiastes was so important and appropriate is a better word. There's a time for every matter under heaven. So remember, Jeremiah was one of the prophets that the people of Israel were not good to. And he said, before I was born, I'm in heaven with God looking down at earth, and you sent me. Before I was forming in my mother's womb, you sent me to be a prophet to these idiot people. Stiff-necked, hard-headed, stubborn people. That you sent me to earth for a mission before I even started forming in my mother's womb. That means that every single person who has ever lived existed before we started forming in our mother's womb, and is here for a reason and for a certain matter of time, which is hard to get our head around because sometimes certain deaths seem to be senseless and like shouldn't have happened. But But that's how great God is. He uses all kinds of ways. But when our mission is completed, we pass. So he was born on Groundhog Day. He died on Leap Day. I think there's comfort in knowing that it was his time to pass. And there was this connection to church, you know. You guys were one of the first members here, you know, at St. Pat's way back in the day. I was just 2 miles down the road at OLPH, growing up on Copeland. But there is this sense, there's a time for things. And that second reading said, I poured out my life like a sacrificial drink. I have fought the good fight. I finished the race. And now it's time for the crown of righteousness and the reward. And that's the goal, isn't it? To live our best, try to do what God's put us here to do, to love, and to leave it on the field. I mean, I was told that he had a tryout for the Pirates. OSU wanted him to play there. And that he had a special pet, a pig named Wee Wee, in college. I've done a lot of funerals, probably over 600. I've never heard about someone having a pet pig named Wee Wee. But I think the humor was there, and that was part of him. And of course, how much he loved his wife and his family. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me, that if you believe in me, love doesn't die and your spirit is connected to God. It keeps on. And so we gather to pray for his soul, because none of us other than Mary and Jesus had their glorified body while still on earth, right? So there's always some transition. So for 2,000 years, we gather to pray for them. But also you can begin to ask for his intercession. Papa, go to God for me. Pray for me. We ask for people's prayers while we live, right? And so we ask for their prayers as well. You'd be amazed how powerful prayers to our loved ones are. For the last few months, after my own mother died, several times a day, I literally, because I think this is odd, I start with my parents and grandparents, and I go through my entire life, all my other aunts and uncles, and each church I was connected with, their patron saint, everybody I can remember in my time at that place, asking for their help on the other side. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God and Jesus, who said, if you believe in me, you'll never die. He's on his way to be with God forever, but physically, his spirit's right here, because only the body died, and he is here with you. Now, in those 600 funerals, that point is usually easy for most people to understand, that we know that Papa or whoever died believed in Jesus deep in his heart, and we know that he'll continue. We'll see him someday. The harder question for most people is, I'm going to miss him. I'm going to miss my loved ones. What do I do now? Well, one of the things our Israeli and Jewish ancestors taught us is that when you tell the story from the past, in the telling of the story, God's spirit is made present. I alluded to that before Kelly gave such a wonderful tribute to him. So, every year at Passover, the Jews tell the story of freedom, of getting out of slavery, and they feel that saving presence and hope. Every time we Catholics pray the Eucharistic prayer and pray the Mass, we tell the story of the Last Supper. And that's one of the ways that Jesus is made present, is in the telling of the story. So I really invite you, as one way to keep Joe's spirit alive, is to continue to tell stories about him. And as you tell those stories, I'm sure that you will feel his presence. It's one way to stir it up, if that makes sense. The other point I would say about how do you feel close to Joe's spirit now is if he is now on the other side and with totally with God, and he does not have his mind and body, right, to be in the way, you can trust that anything that you wanted to say to him that you were not able to, that he will know. You just say it in your heart and intend it to him, and he will know. And since he is totally not in this body, but with God, and that he forgives anything that you're sorry for, and he understands, right? And trust that if he needed to apologize to you, and even if he didn't even realize he did on earth, he does now. And he's sorry. And you pray for his soul and use him as an intercessor. And finally, logic says that the closer that we all get to God while we live, the closer we will be with the spirits of our loved ones. That makes sense, but how do you do that? Jesus actually answered that. They said, Master, where do you live? Because they wanted to know where God was. They wanted to know, and they thought it was a place. And he said, follow me. And in the right translation, he also said, keep on seeking and you'll find. Keep on asking and you'll receive. Keep on knocking, and the door to your heart will eventually open up to feel and be aware of that love, the presence of God that's always there. That makes sense to me. So no matter what your experience of God or church has been in the past, if the last time you went to church, it didn't really bring you closer to God, try another church. There's all kinds of preachers online, all different kinds of faith. Keep on seeking, right? Keep on asking. Ask God, God, lead me to you. If you exist, let me know. Open my heart. Let me try things. I'll try this retreat. I'll try that talk. Wherever you're from, go to things. And if you go to a talk or a retreat and it's awful, or maybe even it's just thinking, wow, these people, this is anti-God, not pro-love, then just do what you would do at a bad movie. Go to the bathroom and don't come back. And keep on seeking, keep on asking. You see what I mean? It's like, and people say all the time, Father, I get it. I love God, but I just pray better, you know, in nature. And I said, absolutely, I understand. But I always want to say, how often do you go? How often do you pray in nature? Church may not be perfect, right? All these different, but they are vehicles and structures to get us to God. And if our goal is God, it can help us to seek, to ask, and to find. Let's take a moment. And first of all, I'd like to invite you to ask for Joe's intercession. For your own, for him to pray for you to God with your other loved ones on the other side, to ask you and help you in your grief, to be able to seek connection with God in your own way and with him and your other loved ones. And also to think about what is one trait and one habit or thing that Joe did in his life that you would like to continue in your life in his honor as part of a legacy for him. Let's now stand together. And I would invite Chris and Katie forward to be able to bring our needs before our God.
For Joseph and all who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, may they see God face to face. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for all the joy, happiness, and loving care Joseph gave to his family, may we always remember the blessing he has been to us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Joseph, as they seek comfort and consolation, may they be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wants to comfort those who mourn. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for the prayers, good wishes, and practical help given to Papa and his family during this difficult time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may have a deep respect for life for all ages and in all forms. May the Lord help us create a better world wherever we live. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let's also pray for all those people that we know who are sick. Let's pray for those in hospitals and nursing homes. Pray for those in hospice, those with cancer and serious sickness. Let's pray for those who are homebound, those who are dying, those who are grieving, those with dementia, mental illness, and addiction. Let's pray for those in Ukraine, in Israel, in Gaza, and all places where there's war and violence. Let's pray for those serving in the military and all people who are struggling with life and faith, relationships and finances and employment. And for all of those people we said that we would pray for, that God will help them and heal them inside and out, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. Increase our faith and trust that you hear and answer our prayers in your way and your time. We ask this all together through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. May we have the gifts brought up from the back at this time.
Please join us in our offertory song, Be Not Afraid, on the inside of your worship aid.
Though you do not know the way.
pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Joe, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ who is our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for us in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel as you are able. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font, the source of all that is holy. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and
drink this cup,
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring us to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the people who serve you in your church. Remember your servant, Joe, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our other brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Welcome them and all who have died in your mercy into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Patrick, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say together, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
If you are not Catholic or do not receive communion in the church, please, we invite you forward in the communion line. And when you get to one of us, just simply fold your hands over. We'll offer you the church's blessing. Let us continue to pray for unity among Christians. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song, I Am the Bread of Life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Joe may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for a moment. It is tradition here at St. Pat's of Heatherdowns that on the day of someone's funeral, that their family comes forward and writes their name, now Joe's name, into our book of life. Now I invite Carolyn and the children to come forward and to write Joe's name in the book of life. Please stand. On behalf of Joe's family, just thank you so much for coming to the church today to pray with them, for them. Thank you to all of you praying with us online. Thanks so much to Ron and the choir for the beautiful music and presence as always. Immediately following the recessional hymn here in church, you are all invited, please, to come to our Holy Family Center, which is the building that way on Heather Downs. It's right next door. It's adjacent to the property. It's just the next building over for a luncheon in Joe's honor. And I encourage you to continue to tell stories of him and to be able to celebrate him, because the funeral mass and luncheon are supposed to be celebrations of the person, but at a sad time for the family. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Joe. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet Joe again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. presenting to God the Most High.
And presenting to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Joe in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Joe in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and are our fellowship with all the saints in Christ. Lord of mercies, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother Joe forever. We ask this together through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, bless Joe's spirit and all of you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This concludes our service for Joe. Let us all go now in peace. Thanks be to God.
Together, thanks be to God.